Hey there, fellow photographers. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to achieve a light and airy look in Lightroom. This editing style is soft, ethereal, and beautiful. So let's dive right in.
I'm going to be editing a few photos from a recent engagement session I did from a couple named Vanessa and Brian. They'll be getting married next year, and we did the engagement session at a park outside of Toronto, Ontario, called Bronte Creek Provincial Park. We did it around sunset, so we have that nice golden hour lighting, and this was a nice location because it's a really big area. It's really pretty, has that kind of rustic vibe that a lot of people like, and it's very quiet, so I find it's great for engagement sessions. All right, so I'm going to be sharing some of my editing secrets that I use to get that light and airy look. And also at the end, I'm going to be highlighting my main tip that I think could benefit a lot of people. So please watch to the end so you can hear my secret on how I edit quickly and deliver images quickly to people. And I think that might help you out. I'm going to walk through three different images and how I go about editing them. This is the first image. This is the after. So that is after I've completed all the editing adjustments. This is the image straight out of my camera. You can see I used my 85 millimeter with this. So 85, which is one of my favorite lenses for portraits. I shot it at f2.5, which created that nice creamy background, which just looks so nice. And then I positioned them so the light is coming in behind them, which creates that nice golden glow. So the light was lower in the sky and creates that nice rim light effect that I really like. So I'm going to go ahead. This is the before, this is the after. So the adjustments are pretty minor, which is great because you ideally want to be able to capture the image as you would like it in your camera and then just do a few minor tweaks in Lightroom. So that's what we're going to do here. So I'm going to apply my basic import preset, which is on the left here, NK basic import preset. That just creates like a nice baseline to start with for editing. And then I'll go in and make some separate adjustments. So I think I mentioned like this preset, I've provided it in the description below and it's free. So please feel free and grab that whenever you get a chance. You can use that however you like to get the light and airy look on your own images. And so once I apply that preset, I go in and I make some more adjustments in the right-hand side of the develop module. But first of all, I just want to talk about exactly what this preset does to your images and how it creates that light and airy look. So the preset will increase contrast slightly, decrease highlights, increase the shadows, so it gives it a little more contrast that way. It decreases whites and increases blacks slightly. And then in this panel, the tone curve panel, the preset will create a backward C effect to your images. And that's what I like to have on all of my images. I use this preset on all of my images so that it creates a consistent look to the edited images. And then people won't be surprised when I deliver images to them. They kind of know what to expect. So this backward C, essentially what it does is it increases the mid-tones. So you can see if I pull that back down, increases mid-tones. So brightens up the mid-tones and then it reduces the highlights so that the highlights aren't really blown out. And it also increases shadows, which gives the image just a little more contrast so it doesn't look flat. So yeah, so on every image, I aim to have somewhat of a backward C in the tone curve. And then in the HSL color panel area, so the preset will select the greens and reduce the saturation slightly of the greens. So you can see this is what it would have been like before. And with the preset, it's around there. So the greens are just a little more muted. And then, let's see, lens correction also enables profile corrections. So I'm going to go in and now that I've gone through what the preset does to your images, I'm going to go in and make some adjustments. So I think the image just looks a little bit on the cool side. Their skin looks a little bit bluish to me slightly. So I'm just going to warm it up slightly. There you go. It's very minor. And then I'm going to increase contrast just a little bit, just to give it a little more oomph. And then I'm going to go in under the tone curve and play around a little bit. So decrease the highlights just a little bit more. Okay, that looks good. Yeah, I like to decrease sometimes the shadows a bit. It just gives more depth to the darker areas in their hair right around here, and just gives the image a little more pop. So I think that looks good. I'm going to move on to the next image now. And this image was taken in a field behind at the back of the property. And there was some like haze coming into the image because I'm shooting into the sun. And it kind of can wash out the colors and make it look a little flat. So I'm going to make some adjustments to compensate for that. This was the after. This was straight out of camera. So, let's see, as you can see, it's a little bit on the cool side, and I feel like it's lacking some contrast here. So, I'm going to go ahead and start the process by applying the basic import preset, which really, it lightens it up, but it also, it's still very cool, and it looks very washed out to me. So, I'm going to go in and make some adjustments here. I'm going to increase the warmth. There we go. I'm going to also crop this because I don't like that sliver of white at the horizon. I think it's kind of distracting. So I'm going to bring that in and try to eliminate that. Okay, there we go. That looks good. It still looks like it's lacking contrast to me, so bump up the contrast a bit. And then I'm going to go into the tone curve. Let's see. Yeah, that, I like the effect of pulling down the darks. It's adding a little more contrast to her jacket. Go back up and bump up the contrast again. I think that looks good. So I'm going to leave it right there. And next image is kind of an interesting one. So this is the after. After I've done the adjustments and edited it. This is before. So you can see here, when I started shooting this, I didn't realize that this scarecrow was here. And I find it distracting. I didn't really need a scarecrow with a plaid red top on, because I really want the viewer to, you know, focus on the beautiful couple in the middle. So I'm going to show you how I get rid of that scarecrow. I'm going to use Photoshop for that and the new tool that's really, really helpful. So I'll show you how I do that. But first, I'm just going to look at the settings here on my camera. So for this image, I used my 50 millimeter, which is another one of my favorite lenses at f2.8. The sun was coming in from behind them again, which is something I really like, especially at sunset. And it's kind of filtering through those trees and giving a really soft appearance on their skin. So now I'm going to start with my process. So I'm going to apply that basic import preset. Okay, that looks good, but again, it's like on the cool side. I like it to be, so I'm going to bump up the warmth quite a bit. I mean, it was sunset and golden hour, and I like it if it does look a little bit warmer on their skin tone. Reduce the exposure slightly. And then I'm going to go back into the tone curve. Let's see. Yeah, reduce the darks a little bit. This tone curve, the adjustments I find can make a big difference to the look of the images. I think that looks good, but this thing, it's an eyesore. And in the past, to remove something like that, it would have been, I find, it would have been tedious for me to get that anything around like a line like that, was just kind of tricky. So I'm going to pull it into Photoshop. Okay, so here I am in Photoshop, and I'm going to use this new tool. So here we use the lasso, lasso. I'm going to circle this little guy. Hit generative fill. Let's see what happens here. Find that not writing out what I want. Sometimes it can figure it out on its own. So I'm going to go ahead and hit generate. Let's see what happens. Hopefully Photoshop can figure this out. Okay, so it gave me three options. Let's see. This is the first option. Looks okay. There's like something weird there though. Number two. I think the first one looks pretty good. Looks honestly better than what I could do by hand. It would have taken me a lot longer. So I'm going to accept that. And then what I do after that point is I flatten the image. So flatten image. And then I'm going to save it. So let's see. It's saved a new version. Here in Lightroom, you can see that scarecrow's gone, which is good. So now we just focus in on the couple. That's with the scarecrow before I edited out the scarecrow, and that's after. So yeah, that Photoshop tool is amazing. I can't believe how good a job it does. But there you go. That is basically my editing process in a nutshell. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.
So to recap how I did this, I first apply a preset to all of my images. And then I go in and I make some adjustments to the images to make them look just right and consistent. Once I've completed that, I will go into images individually and make local adjustments if necessary. I've provided a link to my preset below. So if you'd like to go ahead and use my preset to edit your images and play around with it, just click on the link below and you can grab it now. As I'm sure you're aware, editing photos can be time consuming. Especially if you have a lot of photos like from a wedding. I wanted to let you know my secret on how I can edit my photos quickly and deliver them to clients quickly and make them happy. Last year I got so busy with weddings and I just ran out of time. I didn't have enough time to edit them. So I started outsourcing my editing to a company called Photographers Edit. They did a great job with editing my photos. They were very consistent and they edited the images really quickly, a lot quicker than I could have done it myself. By using Photographers Edit, I was able to deliver my images within 2 weeks of every wedding, and my clients were thrilled with that. So if you were feeling overwhelmed with editing like I was, I highly recommend checking out Photographers Edit. You can get a 50% discount on your first order by using the link that I've provided below. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments and I'll see you next week. Bye.